No, Wendell, not until the phone rings with the news that I've won the role of Cindy in the television movie Tell the Conductor to Stop His Machine.
Maybe they gave your part to someone else.
But nobody could play Cindy better than I could. But nobody could play Cindy better than I could. Stop doing my voice, Wendell. Hello? Oh, hello, Mr. Prokosh. I just knew you'd call. What? Oh, you hired her? No, she's good. Yes, she is a little younger. I could play younger. No, fine, I understand. Thanks for calling. Bye. No! It's over! Oh, boy! My career is over!
Come on, sister. Cheer up!
Cheer up? That's funny. Don't you understand, Wendell? I'm too old to play Cindy, the one role I was born to play. Talk about a sucker punch to the gut, baby. And nothing you can say or do, little brother, will ever cheer me up again.
Let me be me!
No!
Go on, you kids. Beat it. Did you hear that, Mommy? They laughed at my new toupee.
No, dear. They said, do you want to play?
That's not what I heard. Oh, she's a hot one today, Deidre.
Why?
Oh, gee, that was sudden and sad. Third time this month, too. Think of it.
You should be more careful when you clean your windows, Edward.
What are you looking at?
Nothing. Oh, hello, Wendell.
Hi, Mr. Grimley, Mr. and Mrs. Priebus.
Is something amiss?
I don't know. Tina just got upset, and all I did was wish her...
Happy birthday!
It's Tina's birthday? Well, I had no idea.
Miss Malone's birthday. Give me a break. I couldn't be more excited. Oh, and our birthday is just the best. Hats of different colors, people jumping to and fro betwixt various couches. Oh, and I suppose it's not decent when they put pennies on the cake. It's like a joke, because you get chewing them, and then you don't know where they're from.
Maybe we should make an event out of it. Come on, Wendell. There's so much to do. How are you at napkin folding?
You're hurting my sore arm.
I'm good at napkin folding.
Gee, I need a present. Oh, like that would be decent to show up at Miss Malone's party without a gift. I doubt that very much. No way. Gee, I wonder what you might like. Perhaps a cream pitcher in the shape of a cow? Phony newspaper with her name in the headline. We see, now I would love to get that myself.
Thanks.
Oh, and I suppose Miss Malone is you. No is my answer to that question. Perhaps there's something in here that might be appealing. Oh, well, of course. A toaster oven. What could be a more perfect gift for a gal on the go, I must say? Gee, I'd love it if someone gave me a toaster oven. Oh, so now you want the phony newspaper and the toaster oven. Talk about greedy. Let's see. I guess I'd better... Assembly required.
Assembly required? Oh, well, this is just great. I can't assemble anything. I'll go completely mental if I have to, you know,
because it's not within my nature to do things like that. Well, I'll just have to take it back to the factory, no question about it. Sheldon, if you need me, I'll be at the Acme factory. It's in the book.
Right, yeah, like I can read, clown.
Assembly. Gee, this looks like the right department, no question about that. What if they can't help me? Gee, that would be sad. And yet, if they could help me, then that would be happy news.
You don't understand. No one showed up. I'm hours behind. I need someone now.
Excuse me? Is this the assembly department?
Thank goodness you've come. Hallelujah. How'd you get here so fast?
Well, let me try and recall.
No time for that now. Let me show you what to do.
Very good, then.
Wendell, dear, sometimes if you put a twist in it, it gives a more festive effect.
Si, signora.
I don't want to have to tell you again.
Wendell, are you in there? Oh, Wendell, there you are. I'm going for a long walk, and scoundrels! What are you all doing?
We're just getting ready for your surprise birthday party. Surprise!
Birthday party? What? Why would I want to celebrate something which spells the end of my career? I am a flop. a failure. I am a zero.
What is it with your generation? Haven't you ever heard the words lighten up?
Don't talk to your sister that way.
And what's with you? Did a skunk crawl up your head and pass away, Shorty?
Tina!
How could you?
I'm sorry, I didn't mean that. I wish I'd never been born.
You and me both.
Ow! Ow! As Eddie likes to say, that's a pain that's going to linger, no question. Farewell, everyone. And goodbye!
So as the units come down the line, you take this wrench and attach the control knob on the front. You got it?
Sounds simple enough.
Thank you so much. I love you. I'm going to start the line moving now.
Oh, that sounds like fun. What about my toaster oven, I must say?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. I'll take care of it, don't you worry. Okay, here we go.
Very good, then. Oh, there I go. Oh, jumping on new knob. Oh, what am I going to do now? This is so sad. Gee, this is... I would imagine the job stress is quite high in this line of work. Perhaps if I get the proper leverage.
I'd be working on the assembly line. What kind of line?
Assembly line!
My wrench in hand on the assembly line. I'm a happy-go-lucky go. I'm a happy-go-lucky.
And now, the amazing Gustav brothers.
I say, young Ned Grimley seems to be in another spot of trouble. Wouldn't you say, dear brother?
Yes, Ed is about to be squashed flat.
Ooh.
Wham! Ooh, reminds me of something I saw on the road this morning.
Yes, and that leads us to today's topic, compression.
Pardon me, dear brother, but I understood today's lesson was to be kinetic energy.
Oh, don't be absurd, Roger. Kinetic energy, really. I told you over tea and crumpets earlier in the afternoon to abandon such a foolish notion.
Hello. Your name?
Emil.
Ah, then I must give mine. I'm Roger, the one amazing Gustav brother never allowed to choose the experiment.
Now, dear brother, that's poppycock, and I can prove it.
I've never met anyone who could prove poppycock. I think you're bluffing.
Oh, well, then to the magic hole, brother. And we'll travel back to our childhood.
Good heavens, where the devil are we?
London, circa 1940. Dunkirk was just around the corner as we washed our little ears.
I say, Emil, be a sport and pass the soap.
My pleasure, Roger. Today I suggest we test Archimedes' principle of raising bodies of liquid vertically.
No, I was hoping we might study his theory of massive fluid displacement. Sort of had my heart set on it.
Righto, very good then, sweet, sweet brother. Carry on, Roger.
You see, brother, I was an amicable chap.
I feel quite the cad, Emil. Can you forgive me?
Rather, prepare to measure the amount of displaced water.
Roger, Emil. I've told you boys to stop this silly experiments. Once again, you've doused Mrs. Perkins down below. Look, her face is gone. Whose idea was this?
It was Roger's, Mumsy.
There, you blighter. I knew there was a catch. Ah, the Huns here in my bathroom. Get out! Get out! Unskavernati daverna care. That means get out.
It was all Roger's idea, Mumsy.
But why are you wearing those dresses? They're rather odd, don't you think? Perhaps we should get back to Ed Grimley while Emil and I explain this to dear Mum.
Actually, they're lab coats, although they should be taken up just a hair.
Go! There. Well, it's not bad for a first try, I must say. Oh, give me a break. That was close. Because it was... I suppose there's no question about it.
I'm as doomed can be, you know.
It's like...
I doubt I'll ever get to Miss Malone's party now, I must say.
What if she doesn't even notice I'm not there? Or, in fact, thinks I'm talking too much. That would be about as bad as life gets, I imagine.
My life has been nothing but a failure. Why is it I always get the fuzzy end of the lollipop? Will someone tell me why? Because I'm too old. washed up at 25, a quarter of a century, makes a person think.
Think about what?
Who are you?
The name's Clarence. But if you don't want a kick in the shins, you call me Jim. I'm your guardian angel, and I've been sent to help you.
Oh, well, isn't that nice?
What were you talking about before when you said it makes a person think?
Oh, did I say that? I don't remember.
Well, think!
Oh, I guess I meant, you know, what's the point? Why was I ever born?
What was that?
I said I wish I'd never been born.
At last!
Take one down, toss it around where once you saw a thousand. What do you see now, huh? No more bottles of pop on the wall.
Give me a break, Ali. And who do you phone? Oh, and as if that's decent of me worrying about a little leak whilst poor Miss Malone sits waiting for her toaster oven.
Way to go, Mr. Selfish!
I'm gonna win my wings! I'm gonna win my wings!
Lucky you. Well, I guess I'd better be going now.
No! No, you can't go! If I helped you with your problems, then my boss will give me my wings! There!
There's no waiter out here. I don't understand.
Okay, look, I'll spell it out for you, okay? Your life has touched the life of many others if you weren't born. If you make, you know, then if it would make their lives worse if you weren't born, but you don't realize this. So I'm going to show you that their lives would be affected by you not being born, okay?
Why, that's just like that Christmas movie starring Jimmy Stewart.
No, it's not. It's nothing like that at all. What are you saying? I'm not original.
Don't be silly. I think you're a hoot.
So, are you ready to see what their lives would be like if you were never born?
Sure. Sounds like fun.
Let's go.
Well, the apartment house doesn't look any different from here. It's not like a slum or anything.
Well, what'd you expect to affect property values? I want to show you the premises.
Can you get it? Use your incisors.
Oh, my goodness. What happened to them?
They were robbed of every last penny and object of value in their possession.
But what has that to do with me?
Deirdre, this is all your fault.
Now, Leo, I told you not to rent that top floor apartment to two escaped maniacs.
Well, they said they could get us passes to Circus Vargas. Oh, don't try to shift the blame. You're the one who invited them down for canasta.
Shouldn't we help them?
We can't interfere. But you gotta admit, they're worse off since you weren't around to rent that apartment.
Where was I? Was I sick?
No, you weren't born.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
Come on, wait till you see the shape Grimley's in.
Oh, poor Eddie. How could he live without me?
Deirdre, what are you doing? Why did you stop?
Chew on your own ropes, Leo.
Don't you yellow flowers of spring come burst, well, not so much bursting to the surface. It's, well, it's difficult to explain, really.
I thought you said he'd be changed.
I thought he would be. Look, it's not my fault. This guy's clearly not normal.
Oh, my goodness. 3 o'clock. Who knew? Time for the Count Floyd show. I best fix myself a snack, I must say.
Come on. I've seen enough.
Hang on a second. I love this Floyd guy. A lot.
It's time once again for Count Floyd's Scary Stories.
Hi there, kids. Oh, sorry I'm a little late, but I had to stop off at the blood bank and make a withdrawal. All right, now, I got a special treat for you today. Count Floyd is going to show you some super scary home movies. Ooh, monster chiller home movies. And if you don't think home movies are scary, well, just think about them. Everything's out of focus and people walking around without heads because the composition, it's frightening and those things. Anyway, here they are. I want you to take a look at this flick. This has me and some of my relatives in it. Take a look at the old country. You'll enjoy this, believe me. Let's take a peek. Ooh, boy. And here it is, the old country. There he is, that's me, kids. Whoa, and I'm dropping in literally on a friend of mine. And over there, ooh, there's Uncle Buddy and my good friend Freddy Fox. I was playing a trick on him. Here I come in. Whoa, Freddy! I just came in and gave him a quick peck on the neck, you know, a little withdrawal there. And, of course, everybody took it seriously. They came charging over and look, they started firing away at me. Fortunately, they were blanks. As he looked at his gun, and there I go, taking off. Well, aren't those things good? Huh? Ooh, boy, I'll tell you. Ah! What did I... The machines, these things are frightening. They'll just eat you right up if you give them a chance. Anyway, ooh, I'm glad we've got those camcorders now. All right, except we don't have them on this show. All right, next week, we got a real scary story for you. It's called The Spooky Clown from the Middle of the Green Swamp. Ooh, ooh, let's take a look at it. Here's a quick scene. Boy, that was quick. What would... Well, I hope you got that, the gist of it. Oh, it's going to be scary, I'll tell you. It'll give you all, it'll put the goosebumps in, on parade, right up and down your arms. You'll get the heebie-jeebies and the willies on top of that. Oh, boy, trust me, it'll be scary. Anyway, whoa, oh,
I'm telling you, each Floyd show is better than the one before, you know. I mean, talk about consistently entertaining.
I'm glad he can't see me.
Because you're eating all his popcorn.
See, it's the phone.
Not again.
What is it?
Oh, every time a bell rings, another angel gets his wings.
How convenient.
Except for me.
Gee, don't you just love the telephone? There's always such a sense of mystery. Hello, then. You want who? A Miss Malone.
Gee, I'm sorry there's no one here by that name.
In fact, I doubt very much if such a person like has ever been born, I must say. I doubt it. Although, if she were real,
I bet she'd be a pretty decent person to get to know, you know.
Eddie's such a gumdrop ball. I'm not even real and he still likes me. But what about Wendell? I want to see my baby brother.
No, no, you can't see him.
Where is he, Clarence?
The name's Jim. And I told you I'll give you a kick in the shins if you call me Clarence. You want a kick in the shins?
Okay, calm down, will you? So where's Wendell?
Follow me.
Oh, no! My little brother in there? Poor Wendell! Why is he in such a horrible place?
Because you weren't there to take care of him.
Where was I?
You weren't born yet! How many times I gotta tell you that?
Who will come and take me away on this bright and glorious day?
You know, as shocked as I am by his terrible situation, I'm even more surprised he can sing that well.
Yeah, well, it's true he's gotten a chance to develop a singing voice, but when you weigh that against how bad the rest of his life is, I don't think it counts for much, is my opinion.
Wendell Malone, have you finished with the floors, boy?
Yes, for Mr. Beetle, sir.
Then you can wash me car and see that you don't bend the antenna.
I've seen enough.
You have?
Yes, I want to live. I want to have been born.
Super.
Am I alive again?
You betcha.
Oh, thank you, Claire. I mean, Jim. Yes, I guess it's true what they say. It's really a great life after all. And someday I'll play this life in a big art film.
I'm worried about Tina.
I just don't know where she could be.
Hello, everybody. All of this just for me? Oh, thank you. I'm so happy that it's my birthday because it reminds me that I've been born. But where's Eddie? Every time a doorbell rings, an angel gets his wings. Atta boy, Clarence. Oh! I'm sorry, Jim. My mistake.
What's with her?
Package for Tina Malone?
Hey, that's me. It must be the TV I bought for myself for my birthday. When I thought I had the role in that TV movie.
Grimly?
Gee, it's bright in here.
Every time a phone rings, a ninja gets his wings. And a bye, Clarence. I mean, Jim.
Oh, Miss Malone.
In honor of your birthday, I must say, I take great pleasure in presenting you with this high-quality wrench.
Every time someone gives you a wrench, an angel gets it.
Okay, enough already.
Just one moment. Tina, it's for you, dear.
For me? Hello, Mr. Prakash.
Dear Diary, so Miss Malone had quite a decent birthday after all, you know. Seems that the girl who got that role she wanted has a part-time job in a delicatessen and came down with quite a naughty mustard rash. So Miss Malone got the job in the TV movie. Quite that. So anyway... Attaboy, Clarence. Sorry. Green Bell. What is his name? Kevin? Is it Kevin? Gutslow! Mark! Good old Mark!